for, and that's today's show at 9.com.au. That makes my life this foolish
game. You need. All right, how's this for a grab bag of just some of the songs he's written and performed over the years? Three Times a Lady, Easy, Hello, All Night Long and Endless Love. And they really are just the tip of the iceberg. Today we're joined in the studio by a man who needs absolutely no introduction. But I thought we'd give him one anyway. Look up the word legend in the musical dictionary and you'll find a photo of Lionel Richie, who on the eve of his 55th birthday stands tall as one of the most successful artists of his generation. In the mid-70s, he formed the Commodores, an instrumental and vocal band who had a string of hits featuring the velvet vocals and the mellow melodies of frontman Lionel Richie. After the Commodores, Lionel went solo and the hits came thick and fast. Big ballads continued all night long. Lionel even went dancing on the ceiling. He's had 22 top 10 hits in the States, won 5 Grammys, an Oscar, a Golden Globe, and a swag of People's Choice and American Music Awards, selling almost 100 million albums in the process. And now, a new one, Just For You, which sees him return to the charts in a big way. The album debuted at number 3 in the UK. And that's what he's here in Australia to talk to us about. And my heart is breaking just for you, just for you. And my arms are open just for you, just for you, just for you. And we're delighted to have Lionel Richie joining us in the studio. Thank you for coming in.
Good to see you.
Nice to see you.
It's early in the morning, if I'm going to say.
Hey, listen, you've never stopped making albums over the years, but this new one is the biggest hit in 20 years.
20 years. I don't know. Every time
Please
I think,
explain.
Well, I wish I had a formula as why it happened. It's just that I think at the right time, the right place, the stars were all aligned. I can give you a million and one reasons, but the truth of the matter is, it's just that there comes a time when you say, okay, it's time to go back out and do this again. I mean, full time. Mm. And for some weird reason, I just got the bug again. Mm. And let's go out and do it.
What comes first, the words or the music?
Actually, the melody and the mumbles. When I say that, it's like when I write Just For You, it would be and then finally you understand it comes from that. We call them God's words. Then you go back and say, what was I saying? And just for you. But it's just the mumbles first.
So what did Three Times a Lady start out as?
Boy, I want to tell you. It actually came all at one time. Once, twice, three times a lady came out that fast.
Yeah. What can you remember where you were?
I was at my home in L.A., Alabama. But I'll tell you this story about this. It's very funny. My father did a toast one night. I had never heard my father ever stop and get really teary-eyed about my mom. And he said, you know, I want to thank my wife. She's a great lady. She's a great mother. She's a great companion. I think she's just unbelievable. Let me just raise a glass to her. Well, this is my father talking, Mr. Army. You can't crack this guy, right? So, of course, I went home and wrote this song Three Times a Lady. Of course, I went on a television show and made the tragic announcement that my dad inspired me to write this song. And for the rest of his life, he kept looking for the check. Obviously, there's a check that comes with that inspiration.
Yeah. Do you ever try and analyze your success? I mean, Richard rattled off all those songs. You know, songs that people play at their wedding and on other special occasions.
I have tried on many occasions to, you know, if you come from an academic background, there must be a logical reason why you know what you know. In other words, if you're a doctor, you went to med school. You're a lawyer, you went to law school. I think the most fascinating thing about what I do is that I'm an economics major, accounting minor, and I can't read or write music. But I did some research while I was in school. I had the opportunity of interviewing Marvin Gaye and Smokey Robinson and Berry Gordy. I said to them, asked them one question. What music conservatory did you graduate from? And they said, what the heck is that? Mm. Answer to the quiz. They can't read or write music either.
Don't try
Figure
it out.
And so in this case right now, if you talk to any great basketball player or football player, Where did you study basketball?
Just comes.
It comes.
You must get some amazing mail from people who, you know, as Steve said, get married or have anniversaries with three times a lady or hello or truly or easy.
I get too much information. You have to understand how this works. Oh, I get too much information. The joke with me is that Lionel, a guy your size, Lionel, I've made love to you many times. Excuse me, young man, excuse me. You know, and of course they want to
all
go...
night long.
All night long, they want to go to detail. You know, but, and of course the guys, and this is the joke, the guys don't do that much talking. No. They just go, Lionel.
My bad.
Thank you, my man. All right. And of course the women, they come and they tell the whole story about, you know, we were engaged, we were married, the kids. And then they bring all the names of the kids, and I just say, I will take full responsibility for all kids as long as the last name does not say Richard. Everything else is fine.
Which brings us to the question. I mean, you're famous now not just for your wonderful catalog, but...
Your daughter.
Nicole, man. You're Nicole Richie's...
I'm Nicole... How about the other day in England? It was hilarious. And now, let's bring to the stage Nicole Richie's dad. Hold it. Wait a minute. After all this work, it's been null and void now. I am so proud as a father, but I must tell you, my father's words came back to completely haunt me. My father said, one day you will get yours. And I'm sitting there with an afro, boots on, you know, glittered jacket and the whole thing. And I just announced to my father that I'm quitting school. I've joined the Commodores. We're the Black Beatles, and we're going to take over the world. And I couldn't understand why he wasn't happy for me. And he said, one day you will get yours. And sure enough, Nicole came to me and said, Dad, I have a reality show.
With Paris Hilton.
And we're going to go on a farm, and we're going to spoof being farmers. And I use the exact same words my father used. I can't use it on the air right now, but wonderful words of of excitement. And finally she came back to me about 3 months ago and said, after the show's a hit, I told you so, Dad. And of course, as always, you take
that. You got
that
yours.
How much of it was actually a spoof, Lionel? Because, you know, celebrities go to great lengths to say that they try to ground their children and normalize them and not spoil them.
Well, let me tell you something. My daughter has been doing that with Paris Hilton since they were 3 years old.
My goodness.
And I can only tell you, they've been winding Rick Hilton and Kathy and myself, they've been winding us up for years. And the funny thing about it is, everything we told them was not going to be presentable as a young lady. These are, you're supposed to be young ladies. Present yourself in a fine way. They did everything the opposite, and the whole world said, we love you for it. I mean, where's my father's wisdom?
We've got to take a break. Can you stick around?
I will. Glad.
Good. We're back with more of Lionel Richie right after this. Kids.
Is joining us, and listen, we've got a couple of emails for you.
Oh, I'm ready for you.
This is from John Hocknell, one of our viewers, who's asking, how's the golf? Because his son Craig gave you lessons in Phoenix, Arizona once, a short Aussie guy with an American accent.
Oh, yes, I know exactly.
Remember?
God, it's a small world. God, it's a small world. The golf is pitiful.
Okay.
Pitiful. I was inspired for that day only. And then I have a wicked shot, though. It goes here, and then it angles back towards the clubhouse. I have not figured out that shot.
That's
yet.
That's called a hook.
A hook, yes. So I've decided.
You're left-handed or right-handed?
I'm right-handed.
Yeah, okay.
So tennis, of course, now is the sport of choice right now. I'll hold off on my golf. I may hurt somebody.
you play a lot of tennis?
I play a lot of tennis.
Yeah.
A lot of emails have come in from people saying, are you touring? And if you're not this time around, when are you going to tour? I can't believe 1987 was the last time you performed here.
1987, I was hanging off the ceiling here down under. And
thank goodness for that.
We had so much fun. It probably took me at least 14 years to recover from hanging off the ceiling.
That was a huge tour.
Huge tour. Huge, huge, huge tour. We're going to come back in your summer.
Yeah.
And stay here for a while because believe it or not, 14 years, the fan letters have still come in. Where are you? When are you coming back? And so the answer is we are coming back with a vengeance.
Interesting question here from Will Conyers of North Caulfield. Asking, I mean, you started the traditional way with the Commodores. What do you think of shows like American Idol and Pop Stars that give kids an instant leg up?
I will say it like this. It is the best entertainment for amateur entertainment ever. The concept, though, is after 12 weeks, there's no possible way on the planet you can be a pro. Mm. It's the toughest thing in the world. I am now a 27-year overnight sensation. In other words, it takes that long to figure it out. And even then, to take the rejection, it's more than just singing the song. Yeah. You have to learn how to survive it.
Yeah.
And
so it's a television show. Don't get it confused with the music business.
Or even the word long-term talent. Short-term talent, absolutely wonderful. But a career, whole different ballgame. Mm. Whole different ballgame.
Did you have much rejection in the early days?
Or are you... Rejection?
Really?
You live on rejection for the first 5 years because, remember, the road is cluttered. The road to success is cluttered by those trying to come back or trying to make it. So you're constantly in the way. You can't remove the Rolling Stones. They're permanently in place.
Yeah.
And you can't remove Al Green. He's permanently in place, and the Temptations and Diana
Ritchie.
Ross. So here's Lionel Richie in the way of all this stuff. So when you try to make it now, there's so many people that are not willing to move yet. So you have to make your mark.
Were there times for you where you thought to yourself, it's over?
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
So...
Yeah.
Then
what? I'll tell you what it was. At the end of the first four albums, and that's about how long they give you. You know, okay, the reason I joined the Commodores, I said I can make some fast money and then I'll be a lawyer. And then the second album, okay?
You had big hits, Brick House and all that stuff.
I know, but you always think it's gonna cut off. Save your money, and okay, and here comes the third album. Fourth album, fifth album, sixth album. Wait a minute. And then all of a sudden someone says, are you going to use your degree? No, I'm not.
Yeah.
Because it 30 years later, I mean, what are we talking about? That's not in the cards.
After you had so much success, you know, like the last time you toured here, the next few albums still, I mean, I know you sold 2 million copies of one of those albums.
Yeah, right.
But by your high standards, that it wasn't a hit. Was that disillusioning when people wanted to play the old tracks on the radio and not the new stuff?
It's not the new stuff that didn't work. It's you've got such a volume of old stuff that when you walk in the door, they say, play easy.
Mm.
And you go, well, don't you want to hear the new one? Ah, oh, yes, but three times a lady, Lionel.
Yeah, you know,
so, which is a compliment. I tell you what I'm having trouble getting used to, though. Back in the day, the compliment was, ah, oh, Mr. Richie, I have all of your records. I bought all your records. Now it's, Mr. Richie, I've downloaded your entire catalog. I got to get used to that a little bit.
Yeah.
Hey, listen, thank you. We could chat all day.
All day, all night long, too.
All night long.
Yeah.
Thank you so much. Enjoy your time in Australia.
I promise.
Safe travel and come back and tour on behalf of our many
viewers. Nice to meet you.
Thank you.
Viewers,
so nice to meet you.
The new album is called Just For You. It's terrific. If you're a Lionel Richie fan, you're going to love it, especially the ballad track 3, Just To Be With You. It's a great song.
That's a great song.
Thank you. Thank you.
Lionel Richie joining us. We're going to take a break. We'll be back with more right after this break.
There you go.